The beauty industry has introduced so many products in recent years that it often becomes hard to understand specifically which one you need to achieve that perfect makeup look. You might have seen beauty bloggers using powders to set their makeup, but did you actually know the difference between a setting and a finishing powder? Well, if you still think that these two are the same, then today's video is especially for you. Today, we are going to talk about the difference between makeup setting and finishing powders, tips for using them correctly, and which one you should choose according to your skin type. What is setting powder? As simply as it can be put, setting powder is used to set your makeup. It helps to keep your makeup looking better for a longer amount of time and is usually used over liquid foundations and concealers. The function of a setting powder is to lock those liquid products in order to keep them in place so that your makeup doesn't get transferred to other places or rub off easily. What is finishing powder? Finishing powder, just like its name, provides a finishing touch to your makeup. If you're familiar with filters that provide a blurring effect to your face, then we are here to inform you that a finishing powder does that job exactly. It is a great option for blurring fine lines and pores, and you can also use this powder for blending and evening things out if you apply any product excessively. Finishing powder is used at the very end of makeup to provide your face with an airbrush effect. It is basically a translucent powder which can provide both matte and luminous looks according to its type, so you can choose the one according to your skin's preference. What's the difference? Setting powder is basically used to set your makeup, whereas finishing powder blurs your pores and fine lines for an airbrush effect. A setting powder can ensure a better look of your makeup for a longer time, but on the other hand, finishing powder doesn't have the ability to do that. It is just a great option for taking care of your imperfections and enabling your makeup to appear smoother. How to apply? When it comes to setting powders, it is recommended to dampen your beauty blender and press the powder on the oily parts of your face. Experts suggest that you should not blend or rub setting powder excessively, rather go with gentle pressing and rolling. On the other hand, for applying a finishing powder, you can go for a flat top brush or a fluffy powder brush that is large, and the powder needs to be dusted on lightly, and you need to pat the brush gently across your entire face. Remember not to apply too much of the product as it can look unnatural. If you want to use both setting and finishing powders in your makeup look, it is quite okay. But remember to double check if your foundation contains a self-setting mechanism in its formula, because in that case, you can skip using setting powder. Now, after all that explanation, it is time to recommend products according to your skin type. If you want to go for a classic option that has a great blendable texture, then the Laura Mercier Translucent Loose Setting Powder is a great option that you can consider. For oily skin concern, you can opt for Dermablend Professional Loose Setting Powder, as it is dermatologist approved and uses micronized talc in its formula. And for subtle glow, the Nars Light Reflecting Press Setting Powder is a great option and is also known to be useful for ensuring longevity of makeup. Apart from that, when it comes to finishing powders, you can opt for the Tarte Smooth Operator Amazonian Clay Finishing Powder, which has Amazonian clay to provide your face with a matte effect. Also, if you are looking for something that will provide you with an even base while ensuring a natural look, then the Maybelline New York Fit Me Loose Finishing Powder will be a great choice. And that's all for today. Thanks for watching our video. If you liked the video, then hit like and share it with your friends. Comment below to let us know your thoughts. Consider subscribing to the channel if you love our videos, and press the bell icon to get notified of our future videos.